Welcome back to my channel! I am Dimitri, the Watch Doctor, and in my previous video you were able to see how I completely disassembled this vintage Oyer chronograph. Now, all the small parts are professionally cleaned and in this video we are going to put it back together. But before we start, I would like to thank all my new members for subscribing. This helps my channel to move forward and motivates me to keep making as many videos as possible. If you want to support my channel, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. It's free, and if you hit the bell icon, you will be notified whenever I publish new content. Much appreciated. Now we start assembling this chronograph. We will begin with the mainspring, barrel, barrel arbor and cover. I have already installed the mainspring and now I am going to install the barrel arbor. The mainspring does not need much lubrication. For this I use two small amounts of synthetic watch oil, Möbius HP 1300. To easily close the barrel and cover, I use a barrel cover closure tool. And always check that the cover fits well. After a short break, we can continue working. Do not wind the watch too much, because the escape wheel is not installed yet, and this can put too much pressure on the fourth wheel. And before fully tightening the screw, make sure the escape wheel is properly seated in the jewel. After mounting the pallet fork, it must be lubricated. How to do this you can see in another video, link at the top of the screen right now. So, the basic movement is mounted. Next, we are going to oil the jewels at both sides. Pay attention, we are not going to oil the jewel of the pallet cock. The oiling of the jewels must always be done very accurately. For this, I use my microscope. How to open the Inca Block shock absorber spring and oil the endstone. You can see in my other video, link at the top of the screen right now. Turn the watch so we can do the same at the other side. Before I continue with the assembly of the chronograph part, I let run the basic movement for 24 hours. If then everything is still working, I will continue with the adjustment of the movement. For the adjustment, I use my brand new Witchy Watch Expert 4 device. I have oiled the timepiece as perfectly as possible and cleaned it professionally. Now we are going to look at the result of our work. Here you can immediately read how much the watch is ahead or behind, plus or minus in seconds per day. The beat error is the difference between the clockwise swing and the counterclockwise swing of the balance. In perfect conditions, the beat error is zero. As you know, the balance wheel swings clockwise and counterclockwise. This is the amplitude. The amplitude of a modern watch should be between 275 and 315 degrees. In a vintage watch, an amplitude between 250 and 300 degrees is fine. So, this is a good result. This downward trend shows that the watch is lagging behind. We will try to get the line horizontal. When the line starts to increase, that is a sign that the watch is getting ahead. We will start to get the beat error to zero, which is currently 0.4. We are lucky that this regulator has an adjustable stud holder, which we can easily move. But move it very carefully. You see two lines running apart on the graph. If you get the beat error to zero, you will only see one line. This may take a while, but practice makes perfect. So that looks good. Next, we are going to shift the regulator so that the watch no longer lags. We will have to shorten the distance of the hairspring. In this example, we have to shift the regulator to the right. The principle is actually very simple. Do you make the distance of the hairspring longer, then the watch will run slower. Do you shorten the distance of the hairspring, then the watch will run faster. You can actually compare this with the pendulum of a clock. If you make the pendulum of a clock shorter, the clock will run faster and vice versa. Because the battery of my video camera was empty, the regulating is no longer filmed. I checked the movement in four positions and the results are good. This is the result after the timepiece has been fully assembled. Now we can continue with the assembly of the chronograph part. To install the driving wheel, I use my Horotech hand fitting press. When installing the operating lever, I was not able to film this. It should be mounted like this.